Hello guys, I don't want to take too much of your time. Let's make something real quick. You know, like 5-ish minutes. Last time I tried to do that shit, it ended up taking me almost 18 minutes. So I'm gonna try to keep it small, you know. We're starting at 19:50. My clock is in French. Because I live in Montreal, Canada, biatch. Don't judge me. Okay, really there. So we're starting at 19:50, which is 7:50 p.m. To try and work quick, this is my sampler. It's called Omni Sampler. It comes with MixCraft 7. So to make my workflow more faster, I have like drum sets, you know, like samples, presets where I saved the samples I was using, so I kept them together. And this is an example of my samples. In every plugin, I try to have as many presets as I can, so the next time if I want the same sound, I can recreate it easier. Or if I lose my project for some reason, I still have my sound, so I can recreate it. Yeah, definitely something you should think about doing. So let's try something simple. Yeah. I'm gonna fix that. Of course, I was all over the place. When I go to snap to 1/64, sorry, my bad. I think it's kind of late. Bring that back a little bit. Okay, then you have to start over again. Zoom in. Not so bad. Zoom in. Okay, that's better. That's better, definitely better. Sorry for that. Now all I need to do is loop this. Because every time you're working, you need to make like a 4-bit loop. Usually that's what I do. I'm sorry, I don't like the tempo. I don't like to screw with it, so I just leave it as it is, and I try to work myself within the measures. That's my style. It's not that I don't know how to measure tempo, I know how to do that, I just find it losing more time on that, which I don't find to be significant that much to my workflow. Yeah. Oh shit. See, I screwed up there. I'm just gonna push this. Oh shit. My time is almost over. We're gonna have to keep going. I'm gonna promise you, this is not gonna be more than 10 minutes, but I'm pretty sure you enjoy this if you're watching, so that's not gonna be a problem. Okay. Yeah. Because I'd rather have this be more educational than me trying to show off my skills, because I already know what I know, what I'm good at, and whatever. So there's no point in me just showing off. So. I'm sorry if you hear like the keyboard sounds. I just use my computer keyboard. I got a MIDI keyboard, but I only use it rarely when I'm working on music. My music, because I also make music on the side. That's bad. Terrible. Snap it to the third. I like this. It sounds some kind of shit. Yeah. Yeah. And don't forget to save, of course. And give it a name like GPD. GOPD. I don't know why. Just the name. Into my samples. Into contact. Contact is really. And I got this. Sample pack, it's not like a sample pack, it's an instrument pack. It contains samples from the DX5, which is a very famous piano. I'm sure you heard it. Just a melody I came up with. Screw it up. Sorry. So you need to have like some sort of spontaneity to come up with melody. I noticed that it comes with more practice the more you do. The more you make music, the more you can become comfortable coming up with something on the spot. You don't have to worry about that. Thank you. added in a delay just to add some sort of, as if it was another part of the piano playing in the background. I panned it, just panned it to the right, and made it a little bit longer, and that's what I just did. Some of the frequencies, so now you can move in with the bass. Yeah. So 10 minutes are in, so I guess this is almost it. Man, I'm pretty sure this fucking computer is gonna crash for some reason. Yeah, it's gonna crash for real. But I already saved most of it, so it's no big deal. I'm just gonna close it. I'm gonna open it again. Good thing I saved, right? That's why you have to save your work. So I have to play that shit again. But I don't think it's a problem. I still remember the notes, still remember whatever piano I was using, the sample, so it's not a big deal. Screen up. I drank too much coffee today. Again, I screw up again. Okay, I'm sorry. Thank you, this shit is lit. That's a I'm trying to work quick. I'm sorry again. We were almost done, but the computer had to crash. I don't know if you can hear it, so it's making some noises. The same thing over again to the delay. For the delay, you can use whatever you have. If I remember, I'm gonna put it in the description of the video. It has really good samples. So, now I'm in the bass. Ah, That seems like it. I'm gonna let y'all listen to it. Drum pattern here has some very 90s New York style, you know, like do 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 do. We can change that because we're in the modern times, you know. That's what I like to do, you know. When I finish going down, this is like the skeleton. Seems right. I'll spend more time. So let's go. So this, I just composed this for you. some more shit, but for the most part, this is basically it. You don't need more than this for the most part. But of course, you can do like another counter melody and add in more instruments. You just have this piano, DX5 piano, but you can do more things. Like, even in this software, like, I have so many samples, so much things I can try out, so much synthesizers and shit. So you don't need to use everything, you just use whatever you need. You have to be economic in the way you use stuff. So maybe I might use like an organ or some other a pad for the breakdown or something, but I don't have to use it all over the place. I have to be economic with it. So that's it. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe and good luck with your music career if you're really serious about it. So thanks for watching. Until next time, you have a good one.